how to create a funnel using LinkedIn. So first of all, what is a funnel? Essentially, it's just fancy marketing speak for bringing someone into your world so that you can market to them, right? So the way that we want to do this is with an email address. And that's because, as wonderful as social media is, you don't own Facebook, you don't own Twitter, but you do own your email list. And when you need to communicate something with somebody in your audience or with your entire audience, and you want to make sure they see it right away, then the best way to do that is with email. So they can't be a part of your sales cycle and your sales funnel if they aren't on your email list. So this is something that's very, very important for really for all businesses. So before we get into the funnel, I want to point something out to you about LinkedIn in general. If you have a LinkedIn account, even if you're not active, you might be surprised to know that when someone Googles you, one of the first thing that's going to come up is your LinkedIn profile. And for that reason, it's really important that you spend some time making your profile as strong as you can make it. And LinkedIn will guide you and let you know what it is that you're missing in order for your profile to be good. And as you see on the top right-hand corner, it tells me that my profile strength is all-star. I have all-star status. And LinkedIn wants you to have all-star status as well. So they'll guide you and let you know what's incomplete and what you need to do. Now, one thing that also might surprise you is that these sections, like where it says experience, these are movable. So where you see the arrows, this means if I want people to see my experience first, I can move that up to the top. But actually, I don't want them to see my experience first. What I want them to see first is my summary. Actually, I want them to see my publications first, my funnel that I'm going to show you, and then I want them to see my summary. And your summary is something you really want to develop because many people make the mistake of just copying and pasting their resume there, and it's super boring. People do read these summaries. Write it in the first person and just say directly who you work with and why people would want to work with you and what you're good at and what you do specifically to help people. You'll also notice that mine's really colorful, and that's because I've added multimedia. You can add slide decks, you can add, you know, PowerPoints, keynotes, you can add videos and pictures. So I encourage you to do all that. So the first thing you see are posts that I've written, and then right under that you see publications. Now, when I used to see publications, I never filled this out because I thought, well, you know, this is for people who've published a book or fancy white papers or things in scholarly journals, but actually that's not true. You could put anything here that has a link. And so what you'll notice is that I have listed, it says download your social media checklist, download your blueprint for making a content creation assembly line, and then click here for your free marketing course. So let's look at what happens when we click on one of these. So I'm going to click on download your free social media checklist, and it takes me to a landing page. So if the person wants the checklist, they're going to give me their name and their email address. And same thing goes for the other things, for the blueprint assembly line, and then for the marketing course. Now, if you don't have any freebies set up yet, very easy to put together maybe a list of your favorite industry tools or maybe a checklist that would relate to your niche or industry. So think about what you can create kind of quickly and use it, put it on a landing page and create your LinkedIn funnel. If you have any questions, make sure to send me an email at jennifer@jenlaner.com or send me a tweet at Jennergy, J-E-N-R-G-Y. See you next time.